Hi, my name is Robert Jonas, and I'm the academic dean here at AJ Tutoring. I also serve as our department head for the chemistry department. And I'm here today to talk about a technique I use often in sessions, which helps elevate the experience for students. It helps me go beyond just being homework helper and allows me to sort of connect with the students' understanding of topics. It's a process that I often call leveling. And it's something like this, where a question is provided, maybe on a homework assignment, and a student is going to go ahead and solve that question. My goal, of course, is to help that student not just understand the topic, but thinking bigger picture, what's going to help them be successful on upcoming assignments, quizzes, tests, etc. And so when I have a question that I can work with a student, we want to get it done, we want to get that homework grade up as much as possible, but I'll often take the time to work with that question with the student to sort of enhance it, to provide opportunities to reveal more about what the student understands. One of the common techniques to go with this question is to ask foundational questions. These could be questions related to vocabulary, or maybe something related to some of the specific concepts that are within the question. What I like about this is it allows me to ask a student, point blank, do they understand the terminology that's being used? Now, if I'm thinking about the bigger picture, how does this question fit in with the current unit? What was maybe some of the prior information that came up that's going to really inform this question? And knowing a little bit about the curriculum, what's coming ahead in the curriculum? What's going to be coming up next that this question is related to? Perhaps this is a really good opportunity to see where this will fit in with the overall narrative of the unit. And lastly, if I'm thinking about good test preparation, then I want to do that leveling. I want to anticipate how this might turn into a test question on a given exam and on a given assignment that the student's going to have. I'll use an example. So, one of my favorite units in chemistry is gas laws, because I think it has a nice sort of cadence to it. It has a pretty decent amount of information, but not a lot of complex calculations that have to be done. So here's a question from a particular problem set. I'd have a student read through it, and obviously read through it carefully. I like when students annotate so that I can kind of stop afterwards and ask them to explain things. For example, this question mentions STP, so I'd want a student to be able to define for me what STP means. I'd want them to be able to understand some of the different variables that are coming up. I see volume, I see something about pressure, I even see temperature, so I know those are going to be important concepts. Once we have that established, we're going to go ahead and figure out what particular equation is going to be useful. Given this is gas laws, at some point we probably have been introduced to different expressions, maybe something like Boyle's law, which relates pressure and temperature. And so Boyle's law might inform what we're going to do here. Overall, this is probably a really good introduction to how we think about the ideal gas law. So if I have my student looking at that coming up, this is where I might first introduce it. We're going to be able to solve the question, but I'm going to make sure the student understands some of the little curveballs in here. We're using helium gas. Okay, well, what if we change the gas? Is that going to change the question? We talk about the balloon. What does it mean that the balloon can only go up to 2.5 liters? Don't balloons keep stretching? Well, maybe, maybe not. If I want to elevate this question, I might start thinking about related questions. This question strikes me as being similar to the concept of what a weather balloon operates like. So I might ask a student to sort of understand with me what weather balloons are and how they operate and how they the atmosphere affects them. The temperature is constant. Well, maybe we're going to change that up and we'll have the temperature change as well as the pressure change and see what effect that might have. Ultimately, one question with one approach can be turned into a lot of different follow-ups, and getting the student engaged in that question is a really good opportunity to, again, elevate the experience going beyond just being a homework helper. I hope this demonstration helps. There's a lot of great opportunities in your subject to do the same, and I encourage you to try it at a session that you're having upcoming. I've found a lot of success with it, and I hope you do too. Again, my name is Robert Jonas. Thank you for listening.